I, Councillor Pat Hackett, have been elected the office of Mayor of the Metropolitan Borough of Wirral, declare that I take the office upon myself and will duly and faithfully fulfil the duties of this board to the best of my judgment and ability. I undertake to observe the code of conduct which is expected of members of the Metropolitan Borough. Thank you. particularly through organisations which work with young people, the elderly, the vulnerable, and the underprivileged. So where does my history start and my connection with Wirral come from? As the brochure from the States, as Phil has mentioned before, I was born in Dublin, Ireland, and as a family we came over here, that magical place by the sea called New Brighton, with its bright lights on the promenade, fairgrounds, huge bathing pool, massive football ground and pier. It was a child's paradise, so much to do and see. Unfortunately, over the years, it came shadow of its former self and declined dramatically. And I always remember the words of that song by a famous 1980s group, The Specials, which summed up perfectly the results of decline over the decades. The title which was called Ghost Town, nothing but a ghost town. A little bit about that in a minute. As you can also see in the brochure, I worked at various places along the West School, including the old Easy Crowns Mentorship Office. I'm sure some of you of the same age can remember that. They have shops across Liverpool, Wirral and Chester. So various items of stylish clothing. And as I always say, to the likes of Steve Fowkes, all those years ago, including Berlin bags, remember those? 6-inch bags, 40-inch bottoms, including the bees knees, going to the Chelsea Beach, or Rubens, or Brooklyn, various places in Berlin, and all those little things there. I'm sure Steve's got a lot of but I think that particularly the summons to Council Gilchrist, all those years ago, and probably far away in Shemra, on the stylish metal clothing in the 1970s. I always remember back then, in 1973, the lights going out in the country during the 3-day week. Customers would ask what colour of the single lights in the clothing was. And I looked along with a candle in my hand. Possibly, it's about a candle in my hand. Yeah, no problem, I can't say it now. I say it's black, it could have been blue or brown. By the way, we've 22 players. Yeah. strong box, no welfare consent. His girlfriend said he'd left, there's only way he had to play him. I did, and he made that difference. And we eventually won the game, we didn't lose that season for the year of pregnancy. After the game, we all went to the pub, and those players who had, as I say, been working all week. Yeah? And his weekend got spoiled and ruined by not playing them. Turned on me, really turned on me viciously. So imagine what the few points. It was my fault as a decision maker, managing people, sorting out issues, problems, sounds familiar. As I say, good grounding for us all, as I left in home, believe me, it really was an experience. And you wonder why sometimes we do it, but you did it to be involved because you like to help. I like to help the team and the people. Just like we do to let in members, to make our area better, to change stuff, to understand the bigger picture and the local issues in your area. That's why we as councillors all get involved, to do our best to reward the people we represent. And we do, that's people from all classes. And I wish people understand a little bit more that we are genuine and we do want to be the best for the area we all represent, regardless of the party colours. As the council leader said, in 1994, my political life started with hard work, fun, and yes, sometimes heartache began. And I think, as I said, we all look back and say we contributed to the improvements in public life by our actions, we would be happy. Whether it's helping residents out with their issues, which as we know is 24/7, because that's not right. Public realise the amount of issues that we have to deal with, which are absolutely vast. Just to give you a few, just to let the general public know, antisocial behaviour, traffic, disset, parking, highway repairs, streetlights. You should be saying that. Support shopkeepers and businesses, bring in investments and help you create jobs, dog walking complaints, pollution issues, rising benefits, welfare assistance, care help, and a whole host of other issues which we see on personal issues with too many to this year's life. That way, I would suggest on behalf of local residents, that we as council be working with the officers and our partners, give that reassurance and makes that difference to a person and family's quality of life, specifically targeted combat times. So yes, being a councillor is rewarding but also very, very challenging. Highlights have been many. Two man's mentioned tonight for himself. But being appointed onto the cabinet and deputy back in 2001 as a decision maker with responsibility for regeneration, particularly helping others to shape and mould the youth in Brighton that we're so proud of today, they stand out. And I'll just pause on that for a moment, because I know the reader always says, as he said before, I'll never miss a chance to ensure the Brighton's mentioned at every opportunity. Council and the cabinet, absolutely. And he's right, because I like so many others are proud of the turnaround in the resorts for Jews. The one that was here, yeah, I think, as I said earlier, from that headline, that special song in the 80s, from a ghost town, yeah, to a big regeneration success. And the Jew in the crowd so far of Wirral's presence and ongoing regeneration work. Creating hundreds and hundreds of jobs, turning around the fortune businesses, and has brought the crowds flocking back to the resort in their droves. A lot of people said it couldn't be done, but look at it now. This council, and I mean this council, all this council, has proven wrong. trips at no cost to themselves. They have over 100 volunteers carrying nearly 3,000 passengers, and I feature on the BBC carrying the Olympic flag. And in 2014, they were the national winners of the Canal and Rivers Trust Living Waterways Award for the community, for community and volunteering. And I've just learned that they've been recommended the Queen's Award for volunteers. So these charities will be worthy recipients of the Mayor's Charity during the forthcoming municipal year. I look forward to working with them to ensure the many events tremendous success. I'm sure they continue to make the way they do. Also, at the Mayor's discretion, I decided that money set aside for a general fund for charities or worthy causes that may occur during the next year. Because a little amount can go a long way to help many smaller charitable and voluntary groups that do not have a national profile and sometimes find fundraising rather difficult because they're not too known outside of the local area in which they operate. So that's an extra fund, general fund, which will go a long way to the number of groups during the next year. Finally, to finish, it's a source of pride for myself and my wife to be recognised with this honour on behalf of ourselves and the borough, and the responsibility goes with it. Tonight, with family, councillors and friends here from all aspects of our life, thank you so much for coming and supporting this very special evening for us both and the borough, and we look forward to meeting as many of you as possible.